In this video, we're going to have a look at how to make tables look prettier when you knit your Markdown document. So we're going to use the data that we used in the previous video. So just to remind you, that was a data set looking at how many mischievous acts people committed, depending on whether they were in a group who were given an invisibility cloak or a group that weren't. So in the previous video, we read those data in and had a look at how to lay them out. And we're going to use those data here to create a table of summary statistics. And primarily, we're going to focus on how to make that table look, or any table in a Markdown document, look nice when you knit it. So I'll just explain what some of the code chunks do. And then we're just going to focus on one code chunk in particular that displays this table. So the first code chunk here, this is just a setup chunk. And I've loaded a couple of packages. The here package and the tidyverse package. And then I've just got a bit of code that reads the invisibility data into an object or a tibble called invis_tib. And basically that is where we left off in the previous video. So I've read the same data into an object with the same name. So if we execute that code chunk, that will load the data. Then in this second code chunk, again, don't worry about the specifics of what's going on here. I'm just creating a summary table, basically. So for the data we've read in, I'm creating a table that stores the number of cases in the cloak and no cloak group, the mean mischievous acts in each group, and the standard deviation of the mischievous acts in both groups. And I'm saving this into a tibble called invis_sum. So that's the table that we're gonna display when we knit. So this will work for any tibble or any data frame that you want to display, but we're just going to use this one for the purpose of this video. So if we execute that code chunk, it creates an object, and the third and final code chunk, which is the one we're going to focus on, just displays that object. So it's got this object invis_sum, which I've created in the previous code chunk, and we can see that it's already displayed here, but executing that code chunk, we can see what the table looks like. So in our Markdown document, it's a fairly pretty table. It's got four columns. The first one tells us which group the data relates to, the cloak or no cloak group. Then we've got a column labeled N, which tells us how many cases are in the cloak and no cloak group. A column called mean, which gives us the mean number of mischievous acts. So we can see it was 5 in the cloak group, 3.75 in the no cloak group. And then the associated standard deviation of the mischievous acts in each group. So that looks nice in our Markdown document, but when we come to knit this document, you'll see that that table looks rather less nice. In fact, it looks pretty horrible. So what we're going to do is have a look at how to make that table look pretty when we knit. First thing we need to do is change the top of the code chunk. So put a comma after the R, and we want to set an option here, results equals as is. We're going to use a function in the knitter package, which is the package that knits your document, called kable. And kable needs the results to be set as is. What that basically means is it's going to pump the results into kable just as plain text. So we've got our invis_sum object, and we're going to put a pipe operator. So we're going to feed that object into the kable function. That's kable with a K of knitter. Let's see how this changes the knitted document. Okay, it looks pretty nice, doesn't it, already? So it looks more like a table, it looks prettier, and that, you know, that may be good enough for you. But we can do more. So first off, within kable, we can set an option for a caption. And we put the caption in quotations. So we're going to call this table 1 summary statistics. Let's knit the document again, see what happens. our table now has a caption above it. Notice that we've got lots of decimal places for our standard deviation, and maybe we don't want that. Maybe we want a consistent number of decimal places across the table. We can also do that by setting an option within kable. So within the kable function, if we put a comma, to because it's a new argument we're putting in, and we write digits equals, let's say we want two decimal places, so let's set digits to 2. Then when we knit the document, have a look especially at the standard deviation column. So now our standard deviation column has been rounded to 2 decimal places. We can also do some other things. If you install a package called kableExtra, that's kable again with a K and the extra has a capital E, and load that. So up here, I've already got it installed. So I'm just going to do library kableExtra. And I'm going to run that to make sure it's actually loaded. Once we've been through kable, we can pipe the output of that into kableExtra. And there's a function in particular called kable, again with a K, styling, which gives us some other options that you might want to use. The first option is Bootstrap Options, and if we set this to striped, which we have to put in quotations, then what this is going to do is give us a banded table. You'll see what I mean by banded when we knit the document. So now our table has coloured bands, which can be nice. And finally, I mean, there are lots of other options. It's the kableExtra, you can do all sorts of flashy stuff. But a final kind of simple thing we might want to do is notice that the table is the full width of the document. Maybe we don't want that. It looks quite sort of spaced out. So we can, within kable styling, again, comma to separate this as a new argument, we can set the option of full width equal to false. And this will stop the table from spreading the full width of the document. And if we knit this again, we now have a table that isn't full width. So this is just to summarize a couple of things you can do very quickly to make your tables look nice when you knit documents, or to make any tibble, any data frame that you wanna put in your knitted document, how to make it look nice. You basically feed it into the kable function. Within that function, you can set a caption. You can set the number of decimal places that are displayed within the table. And if you want, you can go a step further than that and use the kable styling function to stripe the table and to stop it being full width. Okay, bye.